Welcome to tutorialsinhand.com. In this video tutorial, we are going to learn what is local variable in Java. So whenever anyone asks you what is local variable, you should have these four keywords in your mind. One is local variable has local scope. They are not assigned any default value and you cannot use any access modifier or static keyword along with them. So we are going to see that with the help of a program example. For now, let's consider that this main is a method, you all know that, right? So in main we have a block. This is the block, and if within this block we are going to declare any variable, suppose a roll number is equals to 1. So we have declared a local variable roll number 1. Why this is a local variable? Because this belongs to this main method. It is within the body of this main method. So if you are trying to access this variable roll number outside this block, you will not be able to do so, because outside this block this roll number does not have any identity. The program Hello Tutorials in Hand does not know anything about this roll number outside this main method. For example, if we try to use this outside this block, suppose result is equals to 3 multiplied by roll number. Just for fun we are trying to multiply it. Don't consider anything logical over here. See, you are not getting anything in the suggestion as well, that roll number does not exist for this, for the program outside the main method. Now suppose you are forcefully writing this roll number, then also you will see there is a compilation error. Why? Because this roll number, what is this roll number, is not known to the program. If you hover your mouse over here, you will see that roll number cannot be resolved to a variable because this roll number is never declared. So if you declare outside this a variable named roll number and then assign it certain value like 3 or 4, whatever you want, so now this will work. But you must remember that this roll number, which is outside the main method, is a different variable than the one that is within the main method. How you are going to understand this? Suppose main is a school A, and then this is something which is outside the school. So within school, a student has roll number 1. So this school knows that who is roll number 1. When it is going to check the register of the school, it will find the details about the student who is roll number 1, right? But when we are outside this method, this roll number 1 does not have any identity. Means nobody knows what is roll number 1 outside the school. Nobody can get any detail of roll number 1. For more better understanding, let's have one more method. Suppose public void school A. So this is another method. Let's copy and paste this over here. Now these two roll numbers are different, they are not same. One is local to main, this roll number is local to main, and this can be used within this block only, and this variable roll number is local to school A and can be used within this school A method only. Okay, so this is what we mean to say by local variable. Its scope is local, means it cannot be accessed outside this method or block. Hope you have understood this one. Now if we try to understand, it is not assigned any default value. For that, suppose we are not assigning any value to this local variable roll number. Now if we try to use this roll number of, or if we try to print this roll number, then we will see that there is a compilation error saying the local variable roll number may not have been initialized. Why? Because we have not assigned any value to it, and the compiler in Java is not going to assign any default value for this local variable. That is why you must always declare some value to any local variable that you declare. Okay, so default value will not be assigned. Now if we try to use any access modifier, say public, private, protected, you cannot use that. Suppose I want to write public, see, there will be a compilation error saying illegal modifier for parameter roll number, only final is permitted. Note this, only final is permitted. You cannot use anything else other than final on this local variable. For example, if we try to go for private, then also the error will persist. Now if we go for protected, then also the error will persist. So you have got it right, you cannot use any access modifier on local variable. So this is something which needs to be deleted. it. Now there is another thing which says static keyword cannot be used. So if you try to use static keyword with the local variable, you will again get the same error saying only final is permitted. So this will also get deleted. Now if you declare it final, it will happily accept this final keyword because final is permitted with the local variable. Now what this final means is will be explained in some other video tutorial. For now, you must have these four keywords in your mind when you are explaining anyone in the interview what is local variable, and you should explain them with the help of a proper example. So hope you have understood what exactly is local variable, why it has a local scope, and what whether default value will be assigned to it or not, and which access modifiers you can use or cannot use, and static keywords can be used or cannot be used. So for now we are concluding this video tutorial. Hope to see you in the next tutorial as well. For now, keep learning, keep enjoying. Please like and subscribe our channel to help us motivate. Thank you.